If you don't drop a like in the next 5 seconds, this will be happening to your Fortnite account. But if you do drop a like, this will be happening. The choice is yours. Hit the like button now. With the release of the new season, I'm gifting my subscribers the brand new Season 6 Battle Pass, as well as skins and emotes from the item shop. So, if you want to have a chance to be gifted, all you have to do is make sure you are subscribed to the channel, you have dropped a like on the video, as well as left a comment down below telling me your Epic Games username. This way, I can add you. Good luck to everyone who decides to enter. A new update is here, and in this video, I'll be showing you everything about it. From leaks to secret items. But before you start, go ahead and leave a like on the video, as well as subscribe. As 69% of you, my viewers, are not subscribed. And if you want to support me, make sure to use code ShuffleGamer in the item shop. If you do use it, comment down below, I used your code, and it will give your comment a heart. Really, just give it a try. Hashtag add. Now with all that out of the way, let's start with the video. The V16.30 patch got released and it included a bunch of new content. First of all, if you own the Manic skin, you received a second and third free edit style for her, named Punk as well as No Mask. And here is what they both look like. Oh yeah, and if you own the Tsuki skin, you actually received a secret edit style for her too. It is named Human and doesn't have an icon yet, as it shouldn't be released. Epic Games is still working on it, but somehow have messed up and have already given players who own this skin access to it. From there, one of the greatest bundles ever will be making its way to Fortnite. It is called the Knights of the Food Court bundle and will include a total of 9 items. Here is what all of them look like, and as you can see, they are pretty much medieval knight skins, based on Lada, Tomato Head, and Beef Boss. They are named the Pico, the Gallant skin, with Buckler Supreme Backbling, the Zarya, the Cruel skin, with Zarian Mantle Backbling, the Sir Burger skin, with Beef Steel Blade Backbling, as well as the Chunky Selsax pickaxe, the Zarian Slicer's pickaxe, and the Durburgarian Battle Spatch pickaxe. Next up, for all you Star Wars fans out there, I have some great news. Next week, May the 4th, Fortnite will be bringing back a bunch of Star Wars content. As May the 4th is actually Star Wars Day. And on that day last year, Epic Games brought back all the lightsaber weapons, as well as gave us this huge Star Wars item shop, bringing back all the Star Wars cosmetics. Now because of leaks, we know what's coming this year. They actually re-edit the E-11 Blaster Rifle, the Mandalorian's Jetpack, as well as the Amban Sniper Rifle. So it looks like we're getting some sort of Star Wars LTN, with a bunch of Star Wars loot. Talking about collaborations, we of course have this season's main crossover with DC Comics. And with the most recent update, we finally received a map change for it. If you make your way over to this exact location right over here on the map, just southwest of Slurpee Swamp, you can find yourself this Batman shack that was also shown in the comic series. And when making your way inside, there are so many secrets to be uncovered. In the corner of the shack, you can find yourself this chalkboard with a bunch of notes written and sketches drawn on it. However, unfortunately, we can't really make up what it reads. But with all these books around, as well as this computer, we can say for sure Batman is trying to find something out here. Also, around this location, you can find yourself a bunch of Batarangs, which might be a hint of Epic Games to tell us they're bringing back both the mythic explosive Batarangs, as well as the mythic Batman grapnel gun that look like this. Oh yeah, and you can even find this unicorn floaty. Now like I said, this collaboration is way bigger than just a new POI. Every 2 weeks, a new Batman / Fortnite 0. Issue is getting released. And these comic books will include a physical code that you can redeem for a free in-game item. The first issue has already been released and gave us the Rebirth Harley Quinn skin. The second issue is going to give us the Batman Zero Wing Glider. The third issue is going to give us the Catwoman's Grappling Claw Pickaxe. Then, the fourth issue will be the Deathstroke's Destroyer Glider. The fifth issue, the Harley Quinn's Revenge Backbling. And the sixth and final issue will give us the Grappling Axe Pickaxe. And here is what that looks like. Now, as soon as this video reaches 10,000 likes, I'll be leaving a pinned comment down below with a code for the Rebirth Harley Quinn skin. Just make sure you redeem it on the Epic Games' official website. And if you guys want me to give away more codes for all the other cosmetics too, then let me know by dropping a like on this video, as well as leaving a comment down below saying hashtag code. And if you guys show a lot of support on this video, I will do it. But just letting you know, if you can't get any of the comic books, then don't worry. All these items will also be coming to the item shop later this season. Talking about the item shop, on May the 5th, we will be getting the Batman Zero Point bundle, and it will include Batman Zero. And this bundle also comes with the battle-worn cape back bling, the grappling axe, pickaxe, loading screen, looking like this. And in my opinion, this is just one of the most epic loading screens ever. Fun fact, at tier 87 of the Battle Pass, you'll be unlocking this loading screen known as the Spire Shadow, looking like this. Not only has the Zero Point bloomed, but we can also see a whole new POI right in front of the Spire, being Gotham City, or should I say, a Gotham City variant of Tilted Towers, that was first introduced to us back in Chapter 1. But with this new collaboration, I wouldn't be surprised if it were to make its return. Next up on the map, a brand new island was just added. You can find it right underneath a Flush Factory, and to be honest, it is just a very mysterious island. It's completely empty and just full of rocks and smoke. But wait for it. In the files, it is actually known as Oro Isle. And because of leaks, we now know Oro is making his way back to the Fortnite Island as an NPC. And by connecting all the dots, we can almost confirm this will be the location you can find him as an NPC at. And talking about the storyline, you can now complete the final challenge of the Spire quest. And just for doing so, you will unlock the Glyph Master Res edit stuff for him. That honestly looks extremely epic and is definitely worth the grind. Now, to complete the final quest, all you need to do is land at the Spire and make sure you take out Boss Res. And although this sounds very easy, he's by far the hardest boss ever to defeat. Not only will he shoot at you with his new mythic explosive bow, but he will also attack you by using his dark force. Now after eliminating him, go and hold the button to collect the Spire artifact. And after doing so, you will complete this final challenge. From there, Epic Games is currently working on the classic comic skins bundle, including a comic version of Meowsles, Peely, and Fishdig. Throughout the battle pass, multiple items can be found hinting towards this. For example, the Cap Llama spray at tier 91 of the battle pass, or this banner icon at tier 88. And these skins are based on this concept from THL Art. Next up, with Epic Games updating the item shop files for both Marshmallow as well as Travis Scott, it is getting more and more likely every single day we will finally be seeing the return of both bundles with all their magic cosmetics. And if that were to happen, here is what it then will look like. Next up, we have a bunch of unreleased skins. So let's go through them real quick. We have the Scrap Knight Jewel skin, the Raptorian, the Brave skin, as well as the Gia skin with all her edit styles. Also, quick reminder, make sure to claim your May crew pack as of right now, since it just got released. And this month, it will include the Dima skin, the Soros Reach pickaxe, the Doom Echo Rap, the Skull Stalker loading screen, as well as 1000 V-Bucks and Save the World axes. Oh yeah, and with the Week 7 challenges now officially being out, you will now be able to complete a total of 60 epic quests, which will grant you the Neymar Jr. exhibition edit stuff, as well as all the other official and final Neymar Jr. rewards. From there, we actually already know what the FNCS rewards are going to be for this season. Whenever the pro players are competing within tournaments for cash, we can watch them sweat and earn some free rewards while doing so. Then being the Secrets of the Ancients loading screen, the FNCS Chapter 2 Season 6 spray, as well as the Championship 2021 emoticon. Oh yeah, and if you own the number 1 backbling, there's actually a secret purple edit style available for it. Just check it out. By the way, the Axe of Champions still exists within the game files. Here is what it looks like, and honestly, I think it is just one of the greatest and best pickaxes ever in the game. And for those who don't know, you can only get this pickaxe by becoming the World Cup winner.